Hey everybody, it's Rachel and welcome to really the first edition of my knitting travels. Everybody has been a little bit more restricted than normal over the past 6 months. I am somebody who loves to travel. I love to knit, so whenever I travel, I try to find something fiber arts related and investigate whatever is close to me in the area. Sometimes a little challenging due to the fact that I have a toddler, and that's not always the best combination with really expensive yarn. And the presence of a global pandemic also presents challenges, but not impossible. So this weekend, we were lucky enough to take a little jaunt up to the Berkshires, which is Western Massachusetts, northwestern part of Connecticut. And we stayed in the Lenox area, and there were two stores that I was able to investigate or to visit. So the first store was called Colorful Stitches. It's in Lenox, and it is right off of the main street. It is such a cute little store. It's lofted, big, open windows, beautiful lighting, lots of little nooks and areas to sit in if we weren't so restricted. So I think that initially on entering the store, the owner wasn't really excited that I was there, probably because I was there with my two-year-old. So I'm sure there was an element of just uncertainty in general, because, you know, people can be challenging sometimes. But I probably didn't excite her to see a toddler. So my daughter was kind enough to escort the toddler out of the store so I could walk around. And at that point, when she saw that I was shopping and wearing my gloves and my mask and respecting the social distance guidelines, she warmed up a little bit. Mind you, I was the only person in the store. But it's a beautiful store. She carries all the high-end yarns, different types of craft kits. She had yarns from Brooklyn Tweed to Hedgehog Fibers to Malabrigo, which is what I wound up picking up when I was in the store. It's a shame because all the cute little nook areas and all the social areas are taped off at this point. I would love to go back and visit in more relaxed times to be able to spend more time in the store, because it's beautiful. It's the place that you want to just grab a cup of tea or coffee, sit down and spend time. So while I was there, I was able to pick up these two skeins of yarn. They are going to be for a gift for somebody. I had been on the lookout for a nice shade of purple. We all have those people in our lives. They're purple people, and you know, some people have a favorite color. Well, when that favorite color is purple, you know it, because it's just everything is purple, purple from head to toe. So I have one of those people in my life who is very special, and this is going to be a gift. And I feel like these two colors complement each other well. I've been looking for a good shade of purple and I found one. So that's that. I'm gonna be casting on with this in the next couple weeks. So I wanna be vague as to what I'm gonna be knitting with it, because it is going to be a gift, but I wound up getting two great skeins of yarn from Malabrigo, and I feel like the price was pretty true to what, you know, I could go online and I would probably pay the same amount. So it's, she didn't upcharge and it wasn't any more expensive. So it was a nice experience to be able to be in the store. The second store was in Stockbridge, Massachusetts, and it was called Prado de Lana Sheep Farm. Unfortunately, we got there and they were closed. It was really disappointing. I looked on their website and just this store looks like it is so cool. I was really excited about visiting the store in particular, but this is definitely a store that I would make the trip up to visit them when they're open. It turns out they were closed because they were actually purchasing a large amount of wool. And what is cool and unique about this yarn store is they really take pride in naturally dyed and natural colors of their fiber. So they find sustainable ways to source this yarn. You can track down, I mean, on their website, you can sponsor a sheep every month, which I thought was so cool. You get updates on the sheep and just the type of the breed and what is so special about the breed in terms of what type of yarn it produces. And of course you get wool every month, so why, you know, makes it even cooler. So, and one of their badges of honor, or one of the things that make them happy, is to show people what color palettes are possible just using natural hues and natural shades from the sheep. So they produce everything. I feel like it would kind of give you an elevated knitting experience in terms of it's something you don't see every day. This store, Prado de Lana, they're taking pride in hand selecting the yarns that they're selling, make sure they're naturally dyed. So smaller selection, but just the unique way to look at crafting. And it's definitely something that, like I said, once they're open, I would love to make another trip to be able to get inside the store, see what they have to offer, and just experience it hands-on. So unfortunately it didn't work out this time. I'm sure it'll work out next time. This part of my weekend was being able to spend some time in nature and being able to make progress on my West Knit shawl that I've been working on what it feels like forever. But I did a lot of knitting on that this weekend, and I have some clips of me being in Beartown National Park. I hope you enjoy them, and I hope everybody is finding themselves safe, well, and healthy. Happy knitting. See you next time.